actually challenged God. He said, if you are with me, give me these two signs. He put a fleece on a rock and he said, if I come back tomorrow, it must be wet. The next day, if I come back, it must be dry. And God answered him these two signs. Why? Because Gideon needed a sign. And even though God said, I am with you, Gideon was still filled with a weakness inside of him. He still had this numerous army coming against him. And how many times in our life we have so many things coming against us? You know what happens when the enemy comes? It brings in fear. When we give in to fear, we give in to our weaknesses. Well, God didn't create us to be weak. He created us to be strong. I mean, the word says, I read to you in Psalms 18, that He is our strength. He is our rock. Now, this story of Gideon goes on. Man, he started off with 32,000 men. Now, imagine going against the army with 32,000 men, an army that cannot be counted. But even though Gideon had his ideas, I mean, how many times do we have our ideas of what we have, our strength, our securities, the things that we put in place? Gideon had 32,000 men, which God reduced up until 300. Then he tells him, with 300 men, you are going to defeat the enemies. How many times in our lives do we see things being taken away from us? And we fall back into fear of, we try to figure things out for ourselves. I mean, it's our human nature to think that I need this in order to succeed. I need these securities. I need this amount of money in order to succeed. But in the end, God doesn't work with our possibilities. God is the God of the impossible. He brings the impossible to the possible realm that we are in today. When we put our strength and our trust in God, then God takes care of everything that we have.